So I'm Sean Wall, and we're down here in the vehicle bay at the National Severe Storms Lab, and we just thought we'd give you guys an update and let you know what's new this year for VORTEX2 2010. So one of the new vehicles that we have in our NSSL fleet this year is a scout vehicle for the UAV crew. The UAVs didn't make it out last year. They had a lot of issues, but this year they're gonna make it out with us. So we just got this vehicle a couple of days ago, so it's still in the process of being constructed, which, as you can see, means not a whole lot of seating available at the moment. What we're currently doing right now is kind of stripping it down and taking all the equipment that needs to go in this car and putting it under the floorboards and under the carpeting and trying to get this vehicle ready to go for the field project when we leave next week. So here we have Probe 1, which is the command vehicle for the mobile mezzanet crew. And unlike the last car, this car is extremely used. It went through quite a beating last year during the Goshen County, Wyoming storm. But we've had a few additions to the cars, and one of the most interesting is the addition of a new instrument shield, which is a new temperature and relative humidity sensor housing. We had some problems with some of the designs that we were using last year, so we've created this one over the course of the past year, and we're really interested to see what kind of data comes out of that, and hopefully we can learn a lot from it over the course of this next field campaign. On the inside of the car, we have a few more additions. Being the command vehicle, this one needs a lot of computing power, so we had to add an additional monitor. So there are two monitors in the back seat for each of the PIs that sit in this car to both view their own individual computers so that we can go through a lot of data all at the same time. We also had a small issue with computing equipment overheating last year on two different days, so we've had to modify the air conditioning system in the vehicle, and we're actually piping the air conditioning system into the compartment that's below the seats to keep all of our equipment cool so we don't have any overheating problems. This is one of the three radar scouts from last year. We had a desk designed last year in here to accommodate all the equipment, but the design didn't work out as well as we hoped it would. There were a lot of hardware problems, and we needed a lot of hands-on activity with the hardware itself to kind of reset things. They also felt like they needed a bigger monitor inside the vehicle to view all of the different programs that they need to look at during operations. So to accommodate those needs, we completely redesigned the entire vehicle. We hand-built our own desk. All the equipment's mounted outside and it's readily accessible. We've accommodated our much larger monitor. This is a 20-inch monitor in here. And so far, the feedback that we've gotten from the design is that they're really excited to use it. It's a complete change from last year, and they're really, really looking forward to being able to use this in the field this year. So that's just kind of a brief overview of a few of the things that we've made changes to this year for the 2010 season of VORTEX2. Hopefully this year's a better severe weather season than last year. It's kind of hard to do a research project without severe weather to research. So I hope you'll join us. Hope you enjoy what you see. Thanks for coming by.